Hello students, today we will study about some more derived gates, more gates, that is the derived gates. The derived gates are NAND gate, NOR gate and XOR gate. So we will study about NAND gate, NOR gate and XOR gate. These gates are called as derived gates. So first we will study about NAND gate, how to verify NAND gate. Okay, so to verify NAND gate we use IC7400. This IC7400 is called as quadruple two input NAND gates. Quadruple means four, so this IC consists of four NAND gates. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the pin diagram of IC7400. This is a 14 pin IC. Pin number 1 and pin number 2 are inputs of first NAND gate and pin number 3 is output. In second NAND gate, pin number 4 and 5 are inputs and pin number 6 is output. Pin number 7, it is ground. That is, this pin is always connected to negative of the DC power supply, 5 volt DC. Okay, this pin is connected to negative terminal of the DC power supply, 5 volt. Okay, then in third NAND gate, pin number 9 and 10 are inputs and pin number 8 is output. In fourth NAND gate, pin number 12 and 13 are inputs and pin number 11 is output. Okay, and pin number 14 plus VCC, that is this pin number 14 is connected to positive terminal of 5 volt DC. Okay, so this is the pin diagram of IC7400. This IC is used to verify NAND gate. We know that the logic equation of NAND gate is Y is equal to AB bar or AB complement. So from this logic equation, we can make the truth table of NAND gate. So here, suppose the inputs are 00, then output is 0×00 and 0 bar 1. Okay, so when inputs are 00, output is 1. Then for 01 condition, 0×10 and 0 bar 1. So output is 1 for 01 conditions. Again for 10 conditions, input conditions, output is 1. And for 11, the output is 1×11 and 1 bar means 0. So when inputs are high, then output is low. 0 means low and 1 means high. So in this way the truth table is prepared or formed. Okay, the truth table of NAND gate is prepared. Okay, now practically to verify this NAND gate we use IC7400. This is the pin configuration or pin diagram of IC7400. So we can select or we can choose any one out of these four NAND gates and we can verify the truth table of NAND gate. Out of these four gates, we can select any one out of these four gates. Okay, so I will select here first NAND gate. So in first NAND gate, pin number 1 and 2 are inputs and pin number 3 is output. So see here, this is a breadboard and I have connected IC7400 here. Okay, the notch side is at left side to me and this is pin number 1. Okay, see here, this is a pin, this is a notch and from left side we can count pin numbers. Pin number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, then 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. Okay, so these are the 14 pins. I have selected first NAND gate. So in first NAND gate, pin number 1 and 2 are inputs and pin number 3 is output. So first we have to connect pin number 14 to plus VCC. See here, this is pin number 14 and we connect this pin number 14 to plus VCC side. Here this horizontal line, it indicates positive line or VCC, and lower side horizontal line is negative. Okay, then we have to connect pin number 7 to ground line. Okay, so this is pin number 7 and I am connecting this pin number 7 to ground line here. Okay, Then we have to connect a DC power supply. Positive terminal of this 5 volt DC is connected here. Okay, that is to pin number 14, and negative terminal is connected to ground line. Okay, that is pin number 7. Pin number 7 is connected to ground line. In this way, DC power supply is connected. Okay, pin number 14 to plus VCC, that is to the positive terminal, and pin number 7 to ground. Okay, now connect one wire to pin number 1. This is a input A, and connect second wire to pin number 2, that is B input. This is A input and this is B input of first NAND gate, and pin number 3 is output. So we have to connect here 330 ohm resistor to pin number 3. Okay, and its other terminal is connected to outside of this IC, and second end of the 330 ohm is connected to anode of LED, and cathode is to be connected to ground line. Okay, so in series with a resistor 330 ohm, LED is connected, its anode is connected to second end of 330 ohm, and cathode is connected to ground. Okay, now if wire is open, then input becomes high, and when wire is connected to ground line, then input becomes low or zero. Okay, so when inputs are 1-1, now these two inputs are open, so inputs are 1-1, so for 1-1 condition output should be low, that is the LED should be off. See here, I am switch on the power supply, I am switching on the power supply. Now here, see here, the inputs are 1-1, so output is low because LED is off. Okay, now I am connecting both inputs to ground so that input becomes 0-0. So for 0-0 conditions, see here, for 0-0 conditions, 0-0 conditions, output is 1, that is output is high. So here LED is on, that is here LED is on, so output is 1. Okay, then for 1 input is low, that is A is low and B is 1. So see here, this input pin number 1 means A, it is connected to ground, so A is 0, A is low, and B is 1. So 0-1. So for 0-1, output is 1. LED is on means output is 1. Okay. Then for 1-0, again the output is 1. For 1-0, output is 1. And for 1-1, output should be, see here, inputs are 1-1, output should be low, 0-0. 1 into 1, 1, and 1 bar means 0. Okay, so in this way, the truth table of NAND gate is verified. Truth table of NAND gate is verified. Okay, for 0-0, when inputs are 0-0, when inputs are 0-0, output is 0 into 0, 0, and 0 bar 1. So output is 1. Okay. And for 1-1, see here, for 1-1, the output should be, this is pin number 7. For 1-1, output should be 0. 1 into 1, 1, 1 bar 0. Okay, so in this way, we can verify the truth table of NAND gate. We can verify NAND gate by using IC7400. You can select second gate also, or third gate also, or fourth gate also. Any one gate can be selected, and we can verify the truth table of NAND gate. Okay, now second gate, NOR gate. See here, to verify NOR gate, we use IC7402. We use IC 7402. This is the pin diagram or pin configuration of IC7402. It is a 14-pin IC, and this is the truth table of NOR gate. Okay, we know that the logic equation of NOR gate is Y is equal to A plus B bar, A plus B bar or A plus B complement. Okay, so see here, when inputs are 0, 0, then output should be 0 plus 0, 0, and 0 bar means 1. So for 0, 0, output should be 1. Then for 0, 1 inputs, 0 plus 1, 1, and 1 bar, 0. Okay. Then for 1, 0, 1 plus 0, 1, and 1 bar means 0. And when inputs are 1, 1, then 1 plus 1, 1, and 1 bar means 0. So in this way, the truth table is, we can prepare the truth table of NOR gate. Okay, this is the pin diagram of IC7402. It is a NOR gate IC, and this IC is called as quadruple two input NOR gates. That is, this IC consists of 4 NOR gates. Okay, so out of these 4 NOR gates, we can select any one NOR gate and verify its truth table. So see here, in first NOR gate, pin number 2 and 3 are inputs. Pin number 2 and 3 are inputs, and pin number 1 is output. Okay, in second NOR gate, pin number 5 and 6 are inputs, and pin number 4 is output. In third NOR gate, pin number 8 and 9 are inputs, and pin number 10 is output. Then in fourth NOR gate, pin number 11, 12 are inputs, and pin number 13 is output. And pin number 14 is plus VCC. Okay, pin number 14 is for, that is, pin number 14 is connected to positive terminal of 5 volt DC, and pin number 7 to negative terminal of 5 volt DC power supply. So, okay, now see here, I am disconnecting the first circuit, and here I am connecting IC7402. This is a IC7402 IC. So see how to make the connections. Pin number 14. Pin number 14 to positive line plus VCC. Pin number 14 is connected to plus VCC. This horizontal line is a positive line. And pin number 7 to the ground. See here, pin number 7. I am connecting pin number 7 to the ground line. Okay. Okay, pin number 7 to ground line and pin number 14 to positive line. This is a ground line. I have connected a power supply, positive terminal to positive terminal of power supply to plus VCC, and negative terminal to pin number 7. Okay, now in first NOR gate, pin number 2 and 3 are inputs. Okay, so I am connecting two wires here, pin number 2 and pin number 3. So this is pin number 2 means it is input A, pin number 2 means input A, and pin number 3 means input B. Okay, so these are inputs A and B, okay, of NOR gate, and pin number 1 is output. So we have to connect here 330 ohm resistor to pin number 1, pin number 1, and its other end of 330 ohm to the other end, we have to connect LED. So its long terminal is anode and short terminal is cathode. So this long leg is connected, that is anode. I am connecting anode to second end of 330 ohm and its cathode to the ground. Okay. So in this way, connections are made. Okay. Pin number 7 to ground, pin number 14 to positive line, that is 2 plus VCC. Pin number 2 and 3 are inputs, A and B. See here the pin diagram. Pin number 2 and 3 are inputs and pin number 1 is output. So for 0-0 conditions, that is when inputs are connected to ground line, inputs becomes low or 0-0. So for 0-0, output should be 1, because 0 plus 0, 0, and 0 bar means 1. The logic equation of NOR gate is Y is equal to A plus B bar. So 0 plus 0, 0, and 0 bar means 1. Okay. Okay. So for 0-0 output is 1. Then for 0-1, for 0-1 output should be 0, because 0 plus 1, 1, and 1 bar means 0. So for 0-1 output is 0. Okay. And then for 1-0, 1-0, again 1 plus 0, 1, and 1 bar means 0. So output should be low. Okay. And for 1-1, output should be 0, because 1 plus 1, 1, and 1 bar means 0. Okay. So in this way, NOR gate is verified. Now, XOR gate. So to verify XOR gate, we use IC7486. It is also 14-pin IC, pin number 7, ground pin, pin number 14, plus VCC. So power supply should be connected to pin number 7 and pin number 14. So positive terminal of power supply should be connected to pin number 14, and negative terminal is connected to pin number 7. So how to make the connections? See, I am connecting XOR gate. See here, this is a positive and this is a negative. Okay. See the pin configuration of IC7486. It is a quadruple two input XOR gates. Means this IC7486 consists of 4 XOR gates. Okay. The logic equation of XOR gate is Y is equal to A XOR B. Or second equation of XOR gate is Y is equal to A bar B plus A B bar. Okay. So this is the first equation, Y is equal to A XOR B. So see here, when inputs are odd, that is when inputs are 0, 1 or 1, 0, then only the output is 1. And for when the inputs are even, that is when inputs are 0, 0 or 1, 1, then the output is low. So for when inputs are even, the output is 0, and when inputs are odd, that is when a number of high inputs, number of high inputs are odd, that is when input that is when number of high inputs are odd, means here only one input is high, so one is odd number. Okay, so output is high. Okay, here also 1-0, the number of high input is odd, because only one input is high, so output is high. Okay, in case of three input XOR gates, when inputs are 0-0-1, output will be 1. But for inputs 1-1-0, then two high inputs, then output will be 0. Then for 1-1-1, in case of 3 input XOR gates, when inputs are 1-1-1, the number of high inputs are 3, that is the number of high inputs are odd, then output will be high. So when number of high inputs are odd, then output is high. So for 0-1, output is 1, and for 1-0, output is 1. But when number of for 0-0, output is 0, and for 1-1, because here number of high inputs are even, sum hai, doni inputs, mon output ka hai, low hai. So when number of high inputs are even, the output is 0. So for 1-1, output is 0. For 0-0, output is 0. And when number of high inputs are odd, Here for odd inputs 01 output is 1, for 10 output is 1. So for 01 output is 1 and for 10 output is 1. Okay. And this is the logic equation, y is equal to a XOR b. So I am selecting first XOR gate out of these four XOR gates. I am selecting here first XOR gate. In first XOR gate, pin number 1 and 2 are inputs and pin number 3 is output. Here IC 7486 is connected. It is a XOR gate IC, quadruple 2 input XOR gates. I am connecting pin number 14. Pin number 14 to plus VCC and pin number 7. Pin number 7 to ground. Okay. Pin number 7 to ground and pin number 14 to plus VCC. Then in first XOR gate, pin number 1 and 2 are inputs of XOR gate and pin number 3 is output. So I am connecting two wires, one to pin number 1 and second to pin number 2, that is inputs A and B. Okay. And pin number 3 is output. So I am connecting 330 ohm resistor to pin number 3. Pin number 3 and its second terminal of 330 ohm to the anode of LED. Long terminal is anode and cathode to the ground line. Okay. This is a long terminal, it is anode and cathode to the ground line. Okay. See here for 00 for 00 output is 0, then for 01 output is 1.